الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل اللهم مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير تولج الليل في النهار وتولج النهار في الليل وتخرج الحي من الميت وتخرج الميت من الحي وترزق من تشاء بغير حساب لا يتخذ المؤمنون الكافرين أولياء من دون المؤمنين ومن يفعل ذلك فليس من الله في شيء إلا أن تتقوا منهم تقاه ويحذركم الله نفسه وإلى الله المصير الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل إن تخفوا ما في صدوركم أو تبدوه يعلمه الله ويعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض والله على كل شيء قدير يوم تجد كل نفس ما عملت من خير محضرا وما عملت من سوء تود لو أن بينها وبينه أمدا بعيدا ويحذركم الله نفسه والله رؤوف بالعباد قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم قل أطيعوا الله والرسول فإن تولوا فإن الله لا يحب الكافرين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وخاتم النبيين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. I think we still in Ramadan. Because some people they make it ختم القرآن yesterday and said خلاص رمضان finish. This reminded me after Ramadan we said Ramadan finish. So we have to come back. After Ramadan, we have to come back from the first point. But what about what we get in Ramadan? He doesn't want to do breaks. So make it Ramadan between breaks. Before Ramadan and after Ramadan. So after Ramadan, we come back to the same point. Of course, we build Ramadan. Inshallah, we'll talk about this again. Tonight we read in Surah Ali Imran in Salat al-Isha. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. If I ask every one of you, you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not?
Yes.
So someone he said no? Because he thinks it's easy to say, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many seconds when you say, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
One.
1 second. So he said, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's okay, inshallah. And our modern shabab, he put eye and he put heart. Red heart. And you say, Allah, mashallah. So eye and the heart means love. Sometimes the heart is not love. Sometimes some people, they have heart, but they have no love. So this disease of the heart, so something heart not very pure, not love, but sometimes hatred. So he said, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is easy to say, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach us in this ayah, you cannot say, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by your tongue. But you have to practice, I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We think that this Jannah is very easy to reach. But Jannah is very difficult to reach. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حُفَّتْ الْجَنَّةُ بِالْمَكَارِهِ وَحُفَّتْ النَّارُ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ. So the Jannah is surrounded by difficulty. Something against your nafs, against your shahawat, against your lusts. You force yourself to do something. But an-nar huffat bil-shahawat, surrounded by desire. You are, everything is easy, you love something. So the an-nar is very easy to reach. But al-jannah, it is very difficult to reach. Because al-jannah up, and an-nar down. When we talk about the degree of al-jannah, we see darajat. Darajatul jannah. Again, darajat, darajah. I think in Urdu, daraja, the word of daraja in Urdu, inshallah. Urdu and Arabic, daraja. And the plural of daraja, darajat. But when you talk about an-nar, you see darakat. What you say? Bilkaf. So the between, we have darajatul jannah. Wa darakat fi darki al-asfali min an-nar. Darki, kaf. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يَرْفَعُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمِ درجات. So when you go to Al-Jannah, you have to go up. But when you want to reach an-nar, down. So down is easy. I was in America and I drive the car on the tunnel on the Greens Point. You know Greens Point, they make a tunnel under like this. When you go to the tunnel, you cannot control your speed. You cannot control your speed. But the car makes speed without you. So you have to control it from speed. You put your leg on the brake, not put it on the gas. So this very smart officer, you know smart officer, he has big dafter and he wanted to make it ticket, and the month khalas will finish. So he wanted to make it 100 ticket in one day. So how he make it a ticket if he go in the freeway, maybe one, two, something like this. So he go in the lowest point in the tunnel, lowest point, and put his car there. So every car come down, he gives the ticket. Every car. It's not only one car, every car. And he prepare himself for this, so he make it machine and make brain together. So go. So line. He did not talk to him, make the ticket and go. Because the line, very big line. So he make it 100 or 200 ticket in maybe half an hour or 1 hour. But what is the meaning here? Everyone come down, he catch him and give him ticket because his speed. So I think about, I said, yeah, if you come down, you come speedily. But if you go up, you need a lot of power to make it this. So this is Jannah and not like this. If you want to reach the Jahannam, it's very easy. So mashallah, your nafs and your shaitan and your environment and your this, and mashallah, the people will so encourage you. So it's all this encourage you, so it will be easy for you to go. But if you go, you said, oh, you don't feel the extreme, mashallah, this with the people, extreme. No, you don't, you swim against the current, so you are out, you are not among us, because you are not in mainstream. I said, you know the Islam, don't follow ministry. La hawla wa la quwwata. You cannot follow ministry. You have to do what the people, most of the people don't do. يعني وإن تطع أكثر من في الأرض يضلوك عن سبيل الله. If you listen to the most of the people, they will mislead you. So the majority will mislead you. But the minority will guide you. Subhanallah, this is mashallah in the deen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, to talk is sheep. You don't, this is free. Talk. We talk, mashallah. But if you come to the practice, it's very difficult. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ Say for them. So this message very important. Why? Because come in the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell us. Tell what he listened from Allah, what he ordered from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ Everyone, inshallah, raise it. I love Allah, inshallah, everyone. Okay. If you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to follow me. To follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if you don't follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you don't love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you claim that is you love, but this liar. If someone said this liar, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. If you follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this evidence that is you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means, don't love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you don't love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ أَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ سبحان الله. So sometimes you say أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ from what he ordered. أَطِيعُ رَسُولَ اللَّهَ from what is in the Quran. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked you, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid the gold and the silk, you don't see this in the Quran. So some people say, Shaykh, give me in the Quran, give me the ayah in the Quran. I said, hadith, no. This hadith, what is this, Shaykh? Hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like the Quran. Because وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. Rasulullah sallam don't say by himself like this, but according to. So أَطِيعُ الله. Sometimes you say, أَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. Ah, وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. أَطِيعُ الرَّسُولَ. He did not say, أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولَ. أَطِيعُ الرَّسُولَ. So if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam order you to do this, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nisa said, مَنْ يُطِيعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهَ. You see the ayah? مَنْ يُطِيعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ. Whosoever obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give permission for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to order and to do, so this you obey Rasulullah. One time this wife came to complain from her husband. And after we finish, I said, please obey your husband. Because this, he has a degree. And don't always to argue him. I am equal for you. I am the, so mashallah. You spent money and also I have salary. So this, we are equal. I said, yes. Give him some. Because he's the leader of the family. He said, no, I will not obey him. I am not slave. So obedience means slavery. I said, okay, we can make a deal. He said, yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to obey your husband. You obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, yeah, I obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I obey him, not because of him, but because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I said, okay, alhamdulillah. In the end, everything is okay. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Oh, so when you tell your wife or tell someone, don't say, obey me. No, ya akhi. No. Who are you to obey? You obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only I ask you what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. So Rasulullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Luqman, he asked Luqman to give advice for his son. So he said, Ya bunayya la tushrik billah, inna shirka la zulmun azim. Don't make it shirk. After this, he said, ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه حملته أمه وهنا على وهن وفي صلاة الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ووصينا. And after this, you finish. And Luqman, come back in the picture. He said, يا بني أقم الصلاة. يا بني لا تشرك بالله. يا بني أقم الصلاة. Between them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took by himself. ووصينا الإنسان. Why you did not ask Luqman to say, Ya Bunayya, obey your father and your mother and your parents. He asked him, don't make it shirk, make it salah, obey me, because I am your father. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the nature of human being. If he said, Ya Bunayya, obey me, he said was the problem of interest. You know interest? You tell me, obey the parents because you are parents. Oh, mashallah. So I'll not listen to you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala come by himself and say, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ. I ask you to obey, mashallah. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. Look now for this conditional sentence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it in the Quran a lot. If you do this, you will get this. It's not free. اذكروني اذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون ادعوني استجب لكم ان تنصروا الله ينصركم ويثبت اقدامكم ان تتقوا الله يجعل لكم فرقان. So if you want to get the fruit, you have to work for this fruit. All of us, he want to make a dua, and he ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to respond to the dua free. Sheep free? No, you have to. Someone, he said, you see dua, Surah Ali Imran? He said, what is the dua, Surah Ali Imran? رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا سَمِعْنَا مُنَادِيًا يُنَادِي لِلْإِيمَانِ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِرَبِّكُمْ فَآمَنَّا رَبَّنَا فَاغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَكَفِّرْ عَنَّا سَيِّئَاتِنَا وَتَوَفَّنَا مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ رَبَّنَا وَآتِنَا مَا وَعَدْتَنَا عَلَى رُسُلِكَ وَلَا تُخْزِنَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِنَّكَ لَا تُخْلِفُ الْمِيعَادَ. You see the ayat? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ. I said, you did not read the whole ayah, Shaykh. You take it, فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ, and go, no. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَنِّي لَا أُضِيعُ عَمَلَ عَامِلٍ مِّنْكُمْ مِّنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى بَعْضُكُمْ فَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وأخرجوا من ديارهم وأوذوا في سبيلي وقاتلوا وقتلوا لأكفرن عنهم سيئاتهم ولا أدخلن. الله سبحانه وتعالى responds the دعاء by condition. What's the condition? To work hard to make it هجرة. The Muslims make it هجرة, make it jihad في سبيل الله. They killed in the cause of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى did not respond the دعاء sheep for the sheep for free. So this mashallah, when you make a دعاء, you have to support the دعاء by عمل. Alhamdulillah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. You follow me. What's the result? يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Forgive you. So don't ask about you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love you. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love you, will forgive your zunub. Masha Allah. So this, you have to do your part. And the leaf is another one, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill his promise and doesn't break his promise abadan. Inna Allah la yukhlifu al-mi'ad. Inna Allah la yukhlifu. Qul in kuntum tuhibbun Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah wa yaghfir lakum dhunub. Sheikh Mamdouh yesterday in the fundraising, he said, Allahumma ja'alhu min alladhina radiyallahu anhum wa radu an. You remember this? Radiyallahu anhum. Again, radiyallahu anhum. Radiyallahu anhum, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pleased with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy with them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded them. But the second one, something we cannot understand. How you be satisfied about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala satisfied about you? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you are satisfied about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Said, who am I to be satisfied about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Yeah, you have to be satisfied about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to be pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to be happy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? Two things, inshallah, I'll finish it quickly because this will make Salat al-Taraweeh. The first one, to be satisfied about takalif. Yani what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said for you, do or don't do. All the Islam, two words. Islam, all Islam. Two words. What's two words? Does and the don'ts. All our life. Does and don'ts. But take does and the don'ts not from anyone, but from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you are satisfied about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said for you, do? You are happy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said don't do? If you are happy, you submit. Don't argue. Don't say, oh, but riba haram, but business, money, this is a life to do this, we cannot share. If we, inshallah, will not do anything in the bank. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Oh, mashallah. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks something, what do you say? Sami'ana. You know, sami'ana wa ta'ala, two stages. The first stage, sami'na. Second stage, all of us, we say sami'na. Mu'mineen said sami'na, kafirin said sami'na, munafiqin said sami'na. But the come difference in second stage. Second stage, some people ata'na, and some people asayna. So he said, qalu sami'na wa asayna. Sami'na wa ata'na. So also, it is very easy to listen. Someone listened to me, said, oh, Shaykh Mustafa, listen. After he listened, said, okay, thank you. Said, what's thank you? I'll not obey you. I have freedom. I listen to you. So, alhamdulillah. Oh, so he listened as he liked. MashaAllah, very good listener. But after this, khalas, finished. Oh, MashaAllah. This he out of the dance as he entered. And sometimes, say as you like, I'll not change. Allahu Akbar, I'll not share. Stubborn. So he thinks that he's right. So sami'na wa ata'na. So sami'na wa ata'na. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said for you, do this. Said sami'na wa ata'na. Because the order comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't do this. Sami'na wa ata'na. If you do this, you are satisfied about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you argue with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know the doctor, a lot of doctor here in Shambi Masjid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, gives them tawfiq. And gives them tawfiq to donate also, inshallah. To donate for the masjid, inshallah. Alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him a lot, so inshallah. Alhamdulillah. So the doctor, when you go to the doctor, and he said, okay, come to the room. What the doctor said? Order. Said, Dr. Yusuf, inshallah, order. Lay down. So he lay down. Take a breath. MashaAllah. Take it side. MashaAllah. Alhamdulillah. Your back, oh, your back. Everything, mashallah. You go here and there, according. You look for him like this and say, Sami'na wa ta'an. Sami'na wa? Like this, mashallah. And after this, he writes this. This medicine, take it 3 times. One before food, and okay, mashallah. Allah, this every 6 hours. Not every 8 hours, every 6 hours. Okay. And go for the everyone, make it, mashallah, in يعني, emergency in the home, and say, oh, please remind me, and this, and you take it. Allah. Someone, a very good patient, mashallah, he came and said, doctor, why is this? Why is this medicine? Three times. He said, what? Three times. And what is the medicine content? He said, you are a doctor? He said, no. He said, if you are a doctor, come and discuss with me. You don't know. You come to me here to listen to me, what I said for you. No discussion. Because you are not equal for me. We make this with the doctor, but we don't make it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you, don't argue with him. Why Allah do this and don't do this? You are equal, you are God? No. You are Rasul? No. So you have to submit only and say, Sami'ana. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي فُلُو اتِّبَاعَ. We have two things, inshallah, I'll finish, inshallah, don't worry. Because many people say, you look in the watch, but you don't practice. We see you look. I said, okay, Shaykh Mustafa will finish. But you continue. I said, I make this to be happy, inshallah. But I'll do what I, inshallah. أكرمك الله يسير بارك الله فيك. These two things very very important. What we call إخلاص and اتباع. Two things. You memorize إخلاص and اتباع. إخلاص means make it sincere for Allah, so not for anyone else. No ريا, no show off. Second one, اتباع. Follow Rasulullah. اتبعوني يعني go step by step. Don't go here and go here and give me your back. No. فاتبعوني. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Kahf. Allahu Akbar. Surah Al-Kahf, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم. Say Muhammad, I am human being like you. So everyone said, oh, Rasulullah is a human being like us. So we are equal. We are equal. So he said, well, someone told me, you know Muhammad what he said? I said, who's Muhammad? Muhammad me. In Champion here or in the Bilal Masjid or the, which Muhammad? He said, Muhammad. I said, Muhammad me. I don't know this Muhammad. I said, oh, Muhammad Rasulullah. Ah, yeah, why you did not say Rasulullah? Allahu Akbar. He make it equal for him. No. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا ترفعوا أصواتكم فوق صوت النبي ولا تجهروا له بالقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض أن تحبط أعمالكم وأنتم لا تشعرون. If you sit down in front of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, don't make it your voice raise. So someone said, Alhamdulillah, we are not in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say, no, you don't raise your voice, don't raise your opinion more than opinion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So okay, it's very, very important. So here, mashallah, how you respect Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So here, ittiba' means to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam step by step. MashaAllah, you are follower of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the first one, ikhlas, and so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. But I am different from you. What's the difference? يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. I receive the wahi, not you. So I am bashar with you, it's okay. I can be angry, I this, I marry the nisa, I eat, I drink, I this, but different from you because I receive the wahi. يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ. InshaAllah, you look for this condition. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ. If you hope to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the good shape, يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. What Rasulullah sallam, he does. So this amal Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this amal salih and you follow. So this ittiba' and second one, وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. He has to be mukhlis in his ibad. My brother and sister, very beautiful to see the relationship between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's the relationship? حُب. حُب means love. It's a high statue of love. Now we take love from movie. You know love of movie? Between the girl and love. It's not love, Yashia. It is not love. It's love. This is the heart. You love Allah. You love Rasulullah. You love Islam. You love Tawheed. You love your parents. You love your teacher. You love your elder. You love, so this must be love. You love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love you. فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه أذلة على المؤمنين أعزة على الكافرين. الله سبحانه وتعالى gives a picture of this. إن شاء الله الله سبحانه وتعالى makes this community and make it this gathering إن شاء الله from the people they love Allah سبحانه وتعالى and from the people Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves them and Allah سبحانه وتعالى if loves someone he will reward him, he will give him بغير حساب. So إن شاء الله in Ramadan we expect بغير حساب يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. What's the دعاء we'll do tonight? يا الله أدخلنا الجنة بغير حساب. We don't want to question. We don't want to say because if question would be disgrace. So يا الله take us to الجنة بغير حساب. آمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. السلام عليكم.